After the release of ECW Hardcore Revolution, a lot of critics panned the game for obvious reasons. Acclaim quickly went back to the drawing board and less than a year later released ECW Anarchy Rulz for the Sony PlayStation and the Sega Dreamcast. The intro to the game once again features ECW action set to music. For some reason, this intro has a very buggy looking effect on it, which leads to just a few frames per second being displayed, and honestly, it makes me feel like I'm drugged or something. The menus in this game are both cool and ugly at the same time. I mean, I like where they went with the style, but that color scheme, yikes. The first thing that caught my eye the very first time I played this game was the bio section. This was something we saw all the way back in WWF Warzone, and I always wondered why it didn't return after that. I like being able to check out wrestler stats as well as see what the in-game models look like and even preview each attire. The wrestler selection is a lot like what we saw in Hardcore Revolution, as there wasn't a whole lot of time between these two games. We lost a few wrestlers here like Raven, but also gained some noteworthy additions like Sandman. Even the American Dream Dusty Rhodes made the roster. The arena selection is also a lot of the same. The house show is now the old TV show arena, only the TNN logo was replaced with ECW. You can still create custom arenas with different banners, ropes, and lighting. The entrances seem to be getting more disappointing, even though they've remained pretty much the same. They included some licensed music from the band Dope to make up for some of the generic themes, but it just doesn't fill that void. And I'm a bit disappointed that they were able to have Sandman come out with his kendo stick, but not his beer. I mean, they added his beer drinking animation, but there's nothing there. And I made sure that the content setting was set on teen rather than the default anybody. They edited a lot of language out of this game that made it into the last one. For some reason, they decided to censor this game for a teen rating. They probably figured the mature rating hurt the sales of Hardcore Revolution. I can assure you it wasn't the rating. Acclaim finally decided to simplify things as far as controls go. Instead of button combos for simple moves like a scoop slam, they kept it simple. Simply press left or right with triangle to perform one. I was all right with the basic moves having combos. It was more the finishers that I wish were one button for all. I mean, it's just so inconvenient to pause the game every time I want to perform a finisher. I just don't play the game often enough to memorize these moves. And speaking of finishers, for some reason your opponent will no-sell your finish move more often than not, which is just really irritating. There's also a few new camera angles, but they aren't used much, mainly only during finishers or Irish whips to the turnbuckle. I do like the addition of these though, it helps break things up a little bit. They also added some new moves and reanimated others, even if it wasn't entirely needed. They turned the 5-star frog splash into the lowdown. I can appreciate that they sort of addressed the aging control issues, but I still feel it needed a little more help to compete with the other wrestling titles that were being released at the time. They decided to amp up the difficulty as well, which I didn't see a need for. If I wanted it harder, I would simply adjust the difficulty setting. But now, even on easy, I find myself getting reversed all the damn time, and it also now takes a lot longer to drain an opponent's health meter. Not to mention, they regenerate a lot faster as well, which can lead to some matches that are a little too long for my liking. But again, I don't have that much of an attention span. They changed all of those things, but they left the rules in, which really doesn't make sense for a game based on ECW. You can still be counted out, and you still have to select a certain match types to use any sort of weapons. The new match types, and don't worry, it's more than one this time around. Rage in the Cage. Not that Rage in the Cage. Now, I'll be the first to admit I'm no ECW expert. I know a fair amount about the company, but I can't tell you if this was an actual match type or not outside of this video game. I've never seen it personally. It's pretty much a UFC cage set up in the middle of an ECW venue. There's no ropes, no turnbuckle, just a huge floor area, and 8 walls made of steel. This is kind of a cool match type, but it doesn't really add much. You can Irish whip your opponent into the cage and perform diving attacks from the top, but other than that, there's really no extra gameplay features here. By this time in gaming, the backstage match had become pretty standard in wrestling titles. If a game didn't feature it, it was kind of a disappointment. Well, no disappointment here. That is, based on the fact that it's included. It's still not great, but I still can't believe it made it in the game. The backstage lot is more like an alley, complete with trash cans, a truck trailer, and a fence that you can climb up and dive off of. It also includes a surface area that lacks any kind of texture whatsoever. I mean, did they forget to add this, or did they just get lazy? In addition to the commentary, you're treated to sound effects associated with the urban area of a large city. You'll hear stuff like cars crashing, cats screaming, and even gunshots. I don't even care that it's a step down from what WCW Mayhem had to offer. I'm just glad it's here. Now, what could be more extreme than a ring surrounded by fire? In the blistering brimstone match, you'll battle it out with every intention on dumping your opponent into the lava-like chaos going on outside of the ring. You can't voluntarily leave the ring, and I know you're probably asking, who would want to do that anyway? Me. I would. And I tried. Once your opponent's health is in the red and he or she is dazed, you can scoop him up and dump him over that top rope, and boom! They disappear in a blaze of glory. I really couldn't stop laughing the first time I saw this. The dumpster match is another unique mode and features a dumpster located on the side of the ring opposite the camera. Just like the brimstone match, you'll need to beat the hell out of your opponent in order to dump that scumbag in the trash where he belongs. Just make sure he actually makes it in.
No! Hey, come on!
The table match is not really a table match, but more a match with tables in it. What I mean by that is the match isn't over when the table breaks, which is cool, I guess. I mean, it's more true to the ECW style that way. These tables are quite flimsy, though. I mean, they'll break just from a wrestler exiting the ring near them. You can't move the tables, which is a shame, so you'll be stuck trying to figure out new ways to smash them up where they lie. Also returning is the infamous Acclaim cage match, and if you're not familiar with this, I've covered it a few times now. Also back is the death match, which is a weapons match, and the main difference here is the fact that the weapon attack animations have been reanimated. They now look even stiffer than before and don't feel as satisfying as they once did. This time you have a few more options on how you want to pursue your career. You can play single, tag, or even stable versions of this mode. The fictional jobber characters are back and are just as cheesy and creepy as ever. I get why this mode is still here, but I just don't get why they didn't expand on it. Visually, I don't see any change from Attitude to Hardcore Revolution to this. Unless, of course, you're playing on the Dreamcast. In that case, there are some higher res textures. But really, it's a lot of the same. Now, not to say that's bad, because I always felt these games were a step ahead of other wrestling titles like Nitro and Thunder. I mean, this was only the PS1. Some of the sounds are actually new here as well, like a new 3-count and the addition of Joel Gertner on commentary. The problem is, the new dialogue they got from Gertner is really in-depth, while the stuff from Joey Styles is very simple. This makes the commentary very one-sided, and I sometimes almost forget Styles is even calling the action with Gertner. And sometimes Gertner's long rants can lead to some delayed calls. They even added some new stuff to the Create a Wrestler mode. Okay, so they didn't add a lot, but at least they gave some sort of effort here. The music selection is large once again, and you can also preview a wrestler's voice before you select it, which are some things I missed in Hardcore Revolution. This game somehow manages to be both better and worse than Hardcore Revolution, in my opinion. I love the addition of match types, but I'm not a big fan of how they altered the AI. Acclaim thought they would try to right their wrongs from Hardcore Revolution, but only ended up disappointing more people. IGN gave this game a 3.8 out of 10, which is more generous than even some other reviewers, and while I definitely don't think it's that bad, I still can't praise the game. I only wish we could have seen what a true ECW game could have been.